Alright, so today we're going to be doing Stomacare. First thing you want to do is come in, you want to get some hand sanitizer, clean your hands, don clean gloves, you want to identify your patient using two identifiers, checking their name and date of birth according to their armband, and check my armband, no arms. Next, I put on clean gloves, now I'll come up to my patient, I'll check the stoma that they already have, and I want to come up and remove the old one, ask them how it's feeling, and you'll hear it. Unclip, and you'll take this and you'll measure it and document it and discard it. You'll either empty the bag or change the bag depending on when it was time to change it. Next, you'll come up and you'll remove the old pad and you'll discard it and you'll check the stoma. You'll look at it, you'll make sure it's pink. You don't want it to be swollen, inflamed. You don't want it to be red, or you don't want it to be yellow or black. That would indicate like infection or decreased blood flow. So you look at it, check the coloration, and ask the patient how it's feeling and everything. So then I go measure my bag, discard of it, everything. Then I come back and I make sure that I use a gauze and clean the outside area of the stoma. You want to get all the, any if there's any feces or any paste left on it, you want to clean it, but you don't want to be too rough and irritate the skin because that could cause more irritation and problems. So next you come up after you've cleaned it and you get a new stoma and you measure it and you come up and you cut out and you want it to be about 1/8 of an inch from the stoma. You want it to be as tight of a fit as you can because you don't want any feces leaking out around the stoma. Next, after you've cut it out, you come up and measure it one good time and then you take it off and then you get your stoma paste to decrease any other irritation to the skin. And you put it around, and then you kind of dab it around, make sure it's good, protect all the skin. You don't want to put it in the stoma, but just around the stoma and make sure it protects the skin. Then you get your pad that you've already measured at 1/8 of an inch, place it on the patient, make sure that that's not causing any restrictions or cutting off blood flow. You want it to be a good snug fit. After that, you come up and you get your stoma bag, and you'll hear it click, so it's very important that you make sure that this is good. You can hear it click in there. Make sure it fits so nothing leaks out or anything. After it fits, you get it on there good, you check it, you check, make sure all your seals, everything's good to go. Ask the patient if they're feeling any pain or tenderness or any throbbing, anything like that. So once you're done, you just, again, check, make sure everything's good to go, and then you go back and you document how much feces, how much waste was in the old stoma bag, you document how the patient tolerated it, any drainage, and what the stoma looked like.